I was working out like 4 and 5 times a day, you know, starting at like 5 a.m. ending at like 5 p.m. It was times where I had to make, you know, hard decisions, whether I'm going to go to workout or whether I'm just, you know, get something to eat. After workouts, I would sleep in my car sometimes just to stay at the gym to prepare for the next workout rather than go all the way home because gas at that time was, you know, very expensive. And I sometimes sleep in the gym after workouts. I had a good friend named Tony who ran the gym. He'll just, you know, say, Shannon, you know, you can go in the corner. We'll put you, you know, I got a little mat over there for you, you know, the next workout in a few hours, you know, and I'll pack a lunch. And that was really my daily routine every day, you know. And I had a good friend named Steve Walton. This a year and a half in, my mom had just, I had a conversation with my mother and she told me, okay, it's been, a year and a half. You know, maybe you need to start looking into the field with your degree and et cetera. So I wouldn't say she was giving up on me, but she was just really just looking at it from like a motherly perspective, mm-hmm. trying to show genuine love. Mm-hmm. And but I had a piece about my situation when I was going through it. It's something I really couldn't explain. And I prayed a lot. I fasted a lot. I had a lot of conversations with God. And coming out of each conversation, I felt like, Shannon, you're going to be all right. And so I had a good friend named Steve Walton. This a year and a half in, he invited me to go to travel tour in Mexico. And, you know, I really didn't want to, you know, I really didn't want to go initially. And he, you know, this was like on a Monday. Later in the week on that Friday, he called me. He said, well, he told me just think about it. He called me that Friday, said, we're leaving in the morning. Meet me at such and such place. And, you know, I had prayed about it and I said, I mean, what do you have to lose? You know, this opportunity, this is what I tell people all the time, especially like my little friends that look up to me. I tell them, like, you can't miss any opportunity because you don't know what's on the other side of the opportunity. So had I missed that opportunity, I really don't know where I'd be right now. And we went to Mexico. We played the team that just won the championship the season before. And I played really well. And right after the game, the GM came up to me and took down my information. And once he took down my information, I didn't really think much of it because I had been through that situation before. I come back to Houston. He called me like 3 days later. Was like, hey, Shannon, I got a team for you. You know, when can you leave? I told him I can leave yesterday. So I don't hear from him for like a week. That next Friday, I call him. It's like 11 o'clock at night. It's crazy. And I just had a conversation with my mother. She, you know, she asked me, okay, what's going on? When you supposed to be leaving? I don't have the answers. So I call, you know, the GM. And, you know, he picked up the phone on the first one. He was like, hey, Shannon, I was just about to call you. I sent your ticket to you. You leave at 4 a.m. And I'm like, what? So, I tell my mama, and the crazy part about it, my mama she didn't believe me at first. You know, she was just like, ah, you just talking. So I go in my room, start packing my bags. She coming up. She said, oh, you really leaving? I said, yeah, mama, we on.